Hi, Dallas here. Welcome. Now that we have created the functionality of the RSVP settings form, to actually use it, we need to create a route to the form, and at this time we will also create the route's supporting menu link. We have done both of these tasks before. Let's make it happen. Outstanding. Recall that all routes must be placed in the module's routing.yaml file. So go ahead and open up rsvplist.routing.yaml with me. If you have been following along the videos of this course, you will already have a temporary demo route to the RSVP form we created a while back. It's currently time to remove that route or borrow its structure and replace it with the more needed route to the RSVP settings form. I'm going to replace it. So first, I'm going to update the route name to rsvplist.admin_settings. Then modify the path to be admin config content RSVP list. Notice that this path does suggest that this is an administrative route since it begins with admin config. Keep in mind that this administrative route should likely be reflected with an administrative permission. Next, we certainly need to update the form key to point to our recently created RSVP settings form class. Drupal RSVP list form RSVP settings form. Then switch the title to RSVP list settings. And finally, update the permission to administer RSVP list. Awesome work! Great job! This completes the route to the RSVP settings form. Realize that we completely removed the original temporary form demo route and replaced it with this admin_settings route. We removed the demo route because that RSVP form is intended to be displayed on node pages, and the link to the form itself does not satisfy that condition. All right, double check your code, paying attention to the two-space indentation requirements of YAML, then save the file. Next, let's turn our attention to the second task of this video, creating a menu link for this rsvplist.admin_settings route. Recall that menu links must be placed in their own specific links.menu.yaml file. So at this time, create the file with me. In the base directory of the rsvplist module, create a new file called rsvplist.links.menu.yaml, rsvplist.links.menu.yml. Dun, dun, dun. Super. In this file, enter the following code. Remember two-space indentation. Since we have created menu links before, there's not much to cover here. The link is identified as rsvplist.admin_settings_link. It points to the rsvplist.admin_settings route we just created, and this menu link will be placed as a child link under the parent link with the route name of system.admin_config_content. This parent route corresponds to the Drupal administrative path of /admin/config/content. If you're curious as to how I was able to find the system route name for the /admin/config/content path, I'll demonstrate my process to you now. I simply did a code text search in my code editor for the exact text of the path, with the intention of finding a routing.yaml file that would contain the route name, like this. I highlight the broadest directory I think would contain the route name we are interested in finding. In this case, I indicated the web core directory to search within. Then, I did a special search called findInPath for the text of the URL path /admin/config/content, hoping to see a result for a routing.yaml file somewhere in the search results. It's not immediately apparent, but with some investigating, I see that the path does occur in the system.routing.yaml file, which is highly likely to contain the route name we are looking for. If I open the system.routing.yaml file, sure enough, we have found the route name that we are looking for. Awesome. Let's copy the route name, system.admin_config_content. And then back in our rsvplist.links.menu.yaml file, we can see that this parent route is exactly what we have already entered. Fabulous. So that was a quick tip from me on a process for how to find system route names based on the known path. I hope it comes in helpful for you. So at this point, this concludes the code for the rsvplist.links.menu.yaml file. Double check your code, save the file, and then head on over to your site so we can see the RSVP settings form in action. Great! So as you can rightly assume, the first thing to do is flush the cache. Super! Now, let's make our way to the RSVP list settings form. First, click on configuration. Notice the URL of the path is /admin/config. As you already know, this page provides an overview of various configuration settings of the site. Next, draw your attention to the content authoring section here. This is where we see a link to the RSVP list settings. If you do not see a link to RSVP list settings, be sure you have flushed your cache and then check to make sure that the code of the rsvplist.routing.yaml and rsvplist.menu.links.yaml file are correct and saved in the appropriate location. Now, rather than just click on the RSVP list settings link, I want to reinforce that parent route name and path that we searched for just recently. So since I cannot actually click on the content authoring section from this configuration page, using the admin toolbar, I can click on configuration and then click on content authoring. Yes! Notice that the URL path is /admin/config/content, which is the text that we searched for in our code editor to find the system route name to this path. As you can see, it currently has two children links of text formats and editors and our RSVP list settings. Okay, thanks for being patient. Let's now finally click on the RSVP list settings. Glorious! Notice that the list of currently available node content types shows and that the article content type is selected by default. Thank you, Configuration API. Also, recognize the button titled Save Configuration. Remember, we did not actually explicitly create this button. It was created for us by the config form base class. If this form does not display for you, be sure to check the code of the rsvplistsettings.php. Feel free to check additional options, such as the basic page, and then click Save Configuration. Awesome! The configuration options have been saved. Woohoo! Great effort from you in setting up a route and menu link to the RSVP settings form. I also want to especially acknowledge your efforts in building out the RSVP settings form. Congratulations! Well, this concludes the video. Nice work and happy learning!